Hi guys, welcome back to my channel. It's gonna be the end of the year soon. I don't know how like this year passed so quickly. It's crazy. And we are now at the end of 2017. So I hope you guys actually really enjoyed this year, and I hope this 2017 was a good year for you like it was for me. I don't know, I think it was a pretty good year for me. I was pretty happy, very, very pleased with all of the clients that I worked with, all of the projects that we have been working on. And this year, I also, tried a lot of new things. I was like a boss for the first time. And if you don't know, I actually graduated last year. So I guess this year was really the year that I put myself out there and really committed to something and built it from scratch. So it's a very, very weird feeling, but so far I just like to say a big thank you to all of you guys that have stuck by me through everything, you know, all of these opportunities, watching all of my videos, liking all of my photos, following me on my Instagram, on my YouTube, and even on my blog. Just would like to say a big thank you to you. Like, I wouldn't be here and I wouldn't have all these amazing things, and I wouldn't be able to call this my job if it's not for you. Today we are gonna be talking about the things that I have been loving the whole year. So this video, I'm gonna probably call it like best of 2017, and this video is the beauty edition. So without further ado, let's get started. Let's start with skincare first. Okay, there are some products that I didn't actually bring with me to the studio today because I left them at my boyfriend's place. So for cleanser, I have been loving the Fenkel facial washing powder. And you will find it kind of annoying because I keep talking about the same brand, but that's how you guys know that I truly, truly love it. A lot of cleansers actually strip my skin off of its moisture, and it's very, very drying on my skin if I keep using it, especially when you double cleanse. Like for me, I like to double cleanse. Like, I like to wash my face twice with the facial washing powder because I wear a lot of makeup every day, and it's always very important to make sure that your skin is really clean before you go to bed. So yeah, I would say number one would be my facial washing powder from Fenkel. Then we'll move on to serums. This is my Skin Inc. My Daily Dose. My Daily Dose is actually like a customizable serum that you put three different kinds of serums into one to customize the serum that best suits your skin needs. So for me, I have hyaluronic acid and ceramide in there because my skin is very dry and very sensitive. Throughout the whole year, I think I finished about 4 or 5 bottles, and I'm kind of almost done already with this. Another serum that I use and I would recommend to you guys for anti-aging is Soom 37 Secret Essence. You guys know how much I love that bottle. I finished about 2 bottles this year, and it's really amazing because I only started using that at the later part of the year. I would think it's like June onwards. So I really like that because it's very, very good for anti-aging. Makes my skin feel really like elastic and bouncy after using it. For moisturizer, pick the Fenkel Moisturizing Emulsion. You know, when I think about the product that I liked the most the whole year, I want it to be something that is number one, effective. Number two, like a no-brainer that I always bring around with me whenever I travel as well. Three is not too expensive. It all boiled down to this product. Very hydrating, and I feel that it's, you know, fast absorbing into the skin, but at the same time your skin feels hydrated even after like hours and hours being in aircon room or even being in like cold countries. Here I have with me my Skin Inc. Tri-Light Optimizer device. I talked about this in my January favorites, and I have been using it ever since I got it. Like, this is the device that has 3 different lights. So it has red, blue, and yellow. I know it looks more like a gimmick, but actually, if you give this product a try and give it time, you will actually see a subtle difference that can go a really, really long way. So I like to use this because it gives my skin like a good massage every night, and I use it together with my Skin Inc. Daily Dose. So I just drip it on my face and just massage my skin using this. And it just needs like 5 minutes or 10 minutes every day. I just see it as like giving myself a good facial massage. So now when it comes to my favorite mask, you guys know how much I love all of Fresh's masks. I'm actually separating sheet masks and tub masks, you know, because they are technically different. For tub masks, you actually have to wash them off, and I really like them because you can actually layer a lot of masks on top of it. So if I were to choose one, I really, really like the Fresh Vitamin Nectar Vibrancy Boosting Face Mask. This one smells like jam and it looks like jam as well. And I like it because it really just gives my skin that glow. Not only does it smell nice, it gives my face that glow, but it also has a very slight and gentle exfoliating properties inside. And I really like use it super sparingly because, you know, I don't want to finish it too quickly. For sheet mask, I was deciding between the Fenkel Moisturizing Sheet Mask or my MediHeal NMF Aquaring Mask. And I decided to go with this because I feel that I have been using it and repurchasing it, you know, again and again and again every time I go to Korea. I love this because it is very, very, you know, soaked in a lot of serum. The serum is also very, very effective at hydrating the skin. And it's not as expensive as the Fenkel one, and it's a lot more accessible, I feel, because you can get it in like Watsons, you can get it in like Beauty Language in Singapore, or even just go to Korea to buy. It's about like $1 to $2 per piece. Okay, and I think that's it for skincare. So let's start from how I would usually apply my makeup. I will start with my base first. I don't really use a lot of primers, so I'm not gonna recommend any primer. When it comes to foundation, it was really, really tough as well because I loved a lot of foundations this year. I decided to go with the Lancôme Blanc Expert Cushion simply because it gives me a very flawless finish. At the same time, it is very thin and very light, and the coverage is around medium, and it also leaves me with like a very slightly dewy finish that isn't sticky to the touch. I like this for events and for, you know, just photo shoots in general because it has higher coverage and higher pigmentation. Next, we'll go with concealer. This year, I have been loving my Tarte Shape Tape a lot. You guys would know because I use it in like every single video, and it's empty now, so yeah, it's kind of sad because we don't have this Tarte Shape Tape concealer in Sephora. Like, I'm really just waiting for the day that Sephora or Tarte would bring this concealer in. Basically, it is really, really good because I love this wand. It is huge, like it gets to the places really, really quick. And the formula is very, very creamy, but at the same time, the pigmentation is really good. It's very easy to blend, and it doesn't settle into fine lines. So that's why I like it. Setting powder wise, I don't really have a favorite, so yeah, we'll skip that. When it comes to brows, I really like the Benefit Precisely My Brow Pencil. Last time I was using the Goof Proof, which I really like as well. But recently, I decided to hop over to Precisely My Brows because I'm more into that feathered brow, or like more precise brow kind of look. So I really like this because it is very thin and the pencil is very, very precise. Next up, when it comes to mascara, you know, I tried so many different mascaras this year and I tried my best not to go back to the ones that I always knew I liked, but it was really quite difficult to find one that would match up to my Heroin Make Long & Curl Mascara. This mascara is made for Asian lashes. If you have very sparse and short and straight down lashes, this mascara is really, really good for you because it contains fibers and it has that really like natural curling effect, and it lasts all day. One downside is that it's very, very difficult to remove. So if you want to try this mascara out, I would suggest you to get the matching remover as well because it helps to remove it much, much better. For lipstick, you guys know, like, I have so many lipsticks, so it was really, really tough. But if I were to choose one, I would choose one that I always wear and I always have with me without fail because the shade is super flattering to my skin tone. And it would be this Satin Pencil Lip Lacquer in the shade Dark Salmon from Ari Tam. It's creamy, the pigmentation is amazing. The only thing is it doesn't last very, very long, but I like it because it helps to brighten up my entire complexion really, really well. For eyeliner, I've been loving the Kat Von D Tattoo Liner. It's so old and so worn that you can't even see any words on it right now. So this is the Kat Von D Tattoo Liner that everyone raved about, and I really can see why, because it is very, very opaque. The brush is like short, but at the same time, very easy to maneuver. I really like this and I would repurchase this. When it comes to contour, you guys know this has been a long running favorite of mine. This is the Benefit Hoola Bronzer. I love it because the color is very, very flattering on every skin type, every skin tone. Eyeshadow palette wise, you guys should already know the answer. The Anastasia Beverly Hills Modern Renaissance palette. It is so worn and I love it. Look at how used they are. So I love this palette because it just contains like so many different colors that, you know, can allow me to create so many different looks. Shadows are so pigmented and so creamy, but the only downside is, like I always say, sometimes it can be too pigmented that you just end up looking really messy and muddy. But so far I have been loving this palette. This Fresh Sugar Lip Caramel Hydrating Balm, it is a pretty new addition to my collection. Some of you guys may get a bit iffy about me, you know, just including things that are kind of recent. So I just wanted to say that, you know, this is so good. Like, once you apply it, if you have really, really dry and chapped lips like I do, once you apply it, like before you put on your makeup, like your lips just feel so soft and supple and your lip lines are really, really like minimized. The downside is that it can get a bit messy because it's in a tub form and I have to use my fingers. But, you know, as long as it's effective, I would recommend it to you guys. Then we'll finish it off with a setting spray. I think I included this in my last year's like best of 2016 video. I have been using all year and I repurchased like the big bottle like twice. So this is the Makeup Forever Mist and Fix O2 Spray. It just helps to set my makeup and just tie and melt everything together really, really nicely. And I like to have it with me, like a small bottle in my purse, because whenever I realize that my makeup looks a little bit cakey, like halfway through the day, I will spray this all across my face and it will help to fix the cakiness immediately. So that's it from me for this Best of 2017 Beauty Edition video. I hope you guys enjoyed this video, and if you did, don't forget to subscribe and follow me on Instagram. I'll leave everything in the description box below, and I'll see you next time. Bye!